Back to my channel. In today's video, I think I'm going to do something that I have not done before. We are going to try some amazing makeup products from this amazing brand called Wet n Wild. Yes, I don't think that I have ever tried any makeup product from this brand. So when Amazon randomly thrown this very super affordable, nice looking products to me during one of my searches, I felt very tempted to pick few and try them. So I have randomly selected 5 different products from this brand, products that we use regularly in our makeup, whether it's a party makeup, event makeup, or a natural day-to-day makeup. The primary reason why I picked this brand and the products is simply because they claim to be cruelty-free. Yes, I totally hate animal testing and I love to buy products that are 100% cruelty-free. The secondary reason was the look and the feel of this product. I totally love the packaging and the way this product has been packaged, positioned. That totally kind of made me say yes, go and pick them up. The third thing I like is the affordability. All these products look super nice, super qualitative, and yet super economical. You won't believe I have picked 5 makeup products, including a foundation and a concealer, all just within rupees 1000. Yes, and it's not that some random roadside brand, it's quite a well-known brand in India and abroad. Let me show you the 5 different products that I have picked. The very first one is this Photo Focus Foundation. The second product that I picked is this Mega Color Concealing Stick, also doubles up as highlighter. The third one is this interesting looking eyeshadow quartet. The fourth one is this Ombre Blush and the name is Mai Tai by Your Drink. And the last product that I picked is this Kohl stick in a rose kind of a color, very nude kind of a cream Kohl. I was also contemplating to pick up a lipstick or a mascara, but you know what, I have so many lipstick that I don't use. I normally don't apply lipstick and I feel so bad every time, you know, that I have to throw because they get expired. But nevertheless, I am planning to buy a lipstick and mascara soon, and all depends on how this particular products perform or works with me, or whether I like them or not. So in this video, I am going to not just try these products in front of you for the first time, but will also talk about my first impressions created using these products. And no, it is not a sponsored post by any means. I have bought all these products from my very own hard-earned money. It is more of a, you know, experimental kind of video where instead of plugging everything that the brand sends to the blogger, I feel like trying products that make sense to me or interest me otherwise and telling you all about it. If you are an existing user of this brand, do let me know your favorite products and your experiences thus far. If you too haven't used these products earlier, maybe you can use this video as a reference and try and decide which product you want to buy and which you don't want to buy. But before that, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. I so much love to see you over there. And if you like this video, do not forget to like, comment, and share with your friends. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started. So here I am with a bare face. I've applied a very thin layer of a very interesting serum that I shall be vlogging about soon. And on top of that, I applied one coat of primer. And on top of that, I've applied a little bit of Dermacolor corrector. I have recently reviewed this corrector on my YouTube channel. You can find the link somewhere over here or in the description box below. So the very first product that I'm going to try is this Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation, and the shade that I picked is the Desert Rose. I have tried this foundation out earlier also in my Katrina Kaif makeup video. So this is a very medium, dark, warm kind of foundation over here. I kind of like the package. Let's, you know, cut the chatter and start by applying this. I totally loved the packaging. It is quite a good quality, gives you a very good feel about the product. It is a doe feet kind of an applicator. So I think you have to just take this and apply foundation at different parts. I'll just put some all over my face. So now I'll take the Sigma H3D Kabuki brush and blend this foundation all over my face. I'll just spread it all over my face. I would do the blending later. So the color seemed to be kind of quite a match for my skin. I think this is very good for a very natural kind of a makeup. You know, if you're wearing it in a daytime or for your office or anywhere as such, I think this foundation is quite good for that for sure. It doesn't look very cakey, patchy, and has a very, very natural finish. Now I'll take this Real Technique buffing brush to set it all over my face. It's a very nice fluffy brush, and that reminded me to try some, you know, some brushes from this brand, but somehow, you know, I was like not very sure because I'm very used to using my Real Technique and all, so maybe I'll try them sometime later. So I apply this foundation primarily on my face and a bit on my neck, not much. So if you see the visuals on the camera, it looks quite nice and clean. Without camera, this has given me a nice base, a nice finish on my face, and a very natural one type. I don't feel like I've applied a lot of foundation, or any foundation for that matter. It does gives a very nice matte natural finish. Second product is this Wet n Wild Mega Glow Concealing Stick. It is quite a nice, petite and handy product over here, and quite well sealed with all the product export details, including the manufacturing date of shipping and expiry that we all must know. So this is the total amount of product in your stick. I'll apply this concealer underneath my eyes in an inverted triangle. The product seems quite thick and creamy. Now with the help of my finger, I'll press it back on my skin and try to work around my face. It does blend well with the skin. See, I'm just using my bare fingers to push this product. Light strokes of your fingertips. See how beautifully it is blending. So let me further blend with the help of this setting brush. Hey guys, this is not a makeup tutorial. It is, if you are watching this from this portion, it is not a makeup tutorial. This is trying out some new products. So next in line is this beautiful looking eyeshadow palette. There are too many things about this palette I really love. First, these colors are quite warm and neutral kind of tone over here. So if you are somebody who is a beginner, somebody who's in a hurry, you know, then this comes quite handy because it illustrates even at the backside, showing what is where. This is your transition. Besides, I totally love the small form factor of this one. Look how cute and handy it is. Before we start, let me quickly show you the swatches of all this beautiful looking eyeshadow. Let's start with this first transition color. It's a very nice, smooth, very smooth. This is the peach shade over here. Next, I'll show you the eyelid color. This nice, shimmery brown color over here. Bronzy kind of a brown this is. Yes, bronzy brown is the right word. Ooh, cyan green kind of a color. Look at this. The color payoff seems to be very good. And this is it. There's a hint of a shimmer into that. So this is a very nice bronze color. The only thing is that, you know, this is such a small product, does not have any mirror on it. That's a setback, maybe because they have not put the mirror because they wanted to control the price. But still, you know, I prefer a small mirror, however small it is, in my eyeshadow palette. So I'll start with this transition shade first. I'll pick up it on my brush. You can take any good eyeshadow brush. Hi guys, so I think I should cut short this eye makeup because it will unnecessarily make the video longer. Maybe we'll do a detailed tutorial of this quad sometime later. So I'll finish my eye makeup and talk about my experience. So the color payoff is quite decent. I have a small tip here if you want it to look as bright and dazzling, especially for these two colors, brown and green. I suggest that you wet up your brush a little bit and then pick the color. Here I am, I have done my eyebrows, I have applied the eyeliner, mascara and some loose powder all over my face to set the makeup. Now let's move on to the next product, which is not just a blush but a blush with a very interesting name, Might I Buy You a Drink. It's an ombre blush, and I totally love, you know, the ombre effect that I've seen on the website. The website, the ombre effect look quite different than in real life, but yeah, it's not that bad given that, you know, I like a very neutral, very subdued kind of makeup. I'll take the same blending brush and give it a good swipe. It's more like a highlighter than a blush, a very mild natural highlighter. I should have picked something darker. You look more orangish in the picture than in real life because it is not as orangish. Let me show you this swatch. It's barely there, right? But it's a nice, very champagne, very sparkly kind of a very neutral kind of a color over here. So if you're buying it for, you know, thinking it's a dark color, it's not a dark, it's a very light color. And but this is not bad. This is very this is very neutral, very nice, a good girl kind of a shade. Might I buy you a drink? No. And the final product that I bought from Amazon Wet n Wild range is this color pencil in peach rose kind of a color. It is basically a Kohl pencil, and like I told, I don't know why I have bought this color. Let me show you the swatch. This is the color. It is quite neutral, very nice. I really love this color, and I'll definitely find ways of using it because I like the pencil color. I think I should have bought a black pencil. I think it will be very good for a natural makeup or very low makeup or daily makeup kind of thing. We will use it somewhere and definitely see how well we can use this. So you can use this to extend this cupid brow, your cupid of your lips, not cupid brow. Yeah, this makes your lips look a little bit bigger. So this is a nice pencil, nice looking pencil. If you have a fairer complexion, I think you should go for this because then you can, you know, do a bit of underlining your lower waterline. I think you can, you know, shade your brow bones using this pencil. It's actually very good to shade your brow bones. I really like it. And especially, you know, you can clean up your eye makeup by using it on your upper brows over here. You don't have to go for a foundation if you're not comfortable. Just apply this to give a definite shape. So well, that's the entire haul I have done with Wet n Wild and Amazon.India. So this is my full face kind of a makeup. That's my personal views and my very first impressions using all these different products from Wet n Wild. Overall, I did like some of the products really well. My most favorite product was the foundation, undoubtedly. So let me know, what do you think of these different products, whether you have used them or you're planning to buy. I bought this product in the month of April, and when I did Instagram stories, a lot of you motivated and asked me to do a complete video on this. So thank you for staying connected with me on Instagram and YouTube. If you are not following me already, do follow me there because I do a lot of interesting content on beauty and lifestyle regularly on those platforms. That's all for this video today. I really hope that you like this video. If you do, do not forget to leave a comment, like, and do share with your friends. Do subscribe to my channel. Take care and let me know any videos that you would wish to see on my channel. I'll see you soon with a good lipstick swatch videos. Take care and ciao.